He's the former president and publisher of the Sun Herald, and now he's on the radio. Welcome to Coast View with Ricky Matthews on Super Talk Mississippi Gulf Coast 103.1.
Welcome back to Coast View. I just had that conversation with Dave Dennis was just terrific. Such a smart guy, got a good read on things. If you missed it, you can go to the Super Talk Gulf Coast Facebook page and watch it. You know, Dave's just a really committed leader here in coastal Mississippi. Now we're going to turn the page and move over to Ocean Springs. We've got Cynthia Sutton, who is the executive director for the Ocean Springs Chamber of Commerce and also Main Street Tourism Bureau there in Ocean Springs. And it's great to have you, Cynthia.
Glad to be here. Thanks.
You know, I've said this on my show so many times. The chamber people have a really good sense of what's happening on the coast, especially in this situation, because you get a lot of feedback in the midst of your jobs. And you know, I wish I'd have had you on the show sooner, but we have you now, and we'll come back to you in a couple of weeks, and we'll stay in touch with you, because as I had a conversation with your mayor this week, and Ocean Springs for so many reasons is really important to coastal Mississippi, and it's really, really important that that community get it right, and that we not send the impression that we're an unsafe place to visit, because 80% of the people who come here to coastal Mississippi to visit here come by car. And, you know, Ocean Springs is always one of their go-to places. They might go to Bay St. Louis, Old Town. There's a lot of things they can do, but Ocean Springs is usually on the list, and you well know that. And I know you're really proud of it. So first of all, let's do this. Tell me about who you are. And how long have you been doing this gig? And tell me about your sister also, who's over in Biloxi.
Yes, yeah. You know, I'll start by saying a lot of people get us mixed up. A lot of people don't know that I actually have a twin sister. She works for the city of Biloxi, and I work for Ocean Springs. So it's a fun adventure that we have, but we cover, as I like to say, both sides of the bridge. I cover Ocean Springs, she covers Biloxi. We kind of do similar. I have a background in broadcast journalism, writing, and things like that, and so does she. So we've always wanted to be in either in some form of communication field, and it's kind of neat that we both have ventured into that. She does public affairs for the city of Biloxi, and I am the director for the chamber, but we're the marketing arm of the city, so we also do marketing, advertising, public relations, all that stuff. So it's kind of neat to see how we've kind of fallen into the same field. So people get us mixed up a lot because we're both.
So you have family in the Biloxi Police Department.
I do. My dad and my brother have been Biloxi police officers, so that's kind of a home there. So the Ocean Springs Police Department has kind of picked me up as well and taken me under their arms. So it's good to be part of a police officer family here on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. And that's very important with everything that's been going on.
Well, send my regards to your sister. I think she's doing a great job working with Vincent Creel there. What the city of Biloxi is doing, you know, I came from the media business and was involved in some really significant strategic digital efforts. And what Vincent and she and others are doing with Biloxi TV and their newsletters and their digital stuff and their Facebook social media strategy is really smart. And
it is.
I'm really, really proud of their efforts. So let's talk for a second. The city is beginning to open back up. You had the restaurants have opened up. And so what's the early feedback that you're getting?
It's amazing. You know, from a tourist and local perspective, they are just excited to be out, to be out of their houses, to be in the community. Ocean Springs is such a close-knit community. So for those folks that have been finding creative ways to chat, from like what we're doing here on Skype to Facebook chats to weekly virtual happy hours from one home to the other, the families and the businesses are excited to be open. They are, you know, running at 50% capacity, but Ocean Springs is a pretty busy town. So we have already actually gotten phone calls from visitors that are saying, I've been planning on coming down in May. Is there anything for me to do? Yes.
Wow, that's great. You know, Adele Lyons from the Coast Chamber said that, you know, the number one, before all this happened, the number one call they would get would be about the beach. and about visiting here, and that she's seen a real uptick in people who are saying, can we come to the beach? What's the status of the beach? And so on. I'm sure you hear the same thing, don't you?
Yeah, constantly. You know, our beach stayed open for a while, and, you know, we're a walkable community. So it was really, really good for folks, families, even tourists to get out there and just be a part of just the Mississippi Gulf Coast and be on that beach. And then when it closed, I mean, that's just a part of our lifestyle that we do. So people want to come to the Ocean Springs Beach. It's a very family-fied beach. So I'm sure it's going to get pretty busy soon.
So you guys have a good relationship with the mayor, Shay Dobson, who I talked to this week, and you've actually hosted some town halls with him. And tell me a little bit about the efforts to work with the city to get feedback and progress things in the city.
Well, I think in Ocean Springs, we're a very unique town. You know, one of the aldermen used to go to conferences and say, you have to have a good relationship with your Chamber of Commerce. And apparently that's kind of rare in a lot of towns, but in Ocean Springs, we have, the chamber has a very close relationship with the city, with the mayor and the aldermen. You know, what we do sometimes goes hand in hand. We work really closely with them. We are the marketing arm of the city. So we host a lot of events with them and for them. For the community of Ocean Springs, we don't have any of the, you know, major department stores, casinos as our attractors. So our attractors in Ocean Springs are our festivals, our nightlife, our activity, the beach, like you just said. So the city, you know, we are placed inside the city of Ocean Springs. So we have to work hand in hand with them. So the fun ways that we generate revenue for the city is to host all those events. And like you said, some of the events and town hall meetings that we have hosted with City Hall. I mean, during this coronavirus time, you know, Mayor Shay Dobson is a very a good speaker. He's a public speaker. He likes to get out and communicate with our businesses and our residents. So we've actually helped and hosted two town hall meetings during this pandemic just to keep the business community informed of what's going on. So we work really closely with the city.
It was really interesting to learn that on a typical month, you may have 400 or 500 people that come through the visitor center. Are you beginning to see an uptick there again?
Not as much. Mostly it's, we do have a handful of visitors that are in town. Yes. Mostly it's, locals that are just getting out and beginning to shop. So we're beginning to see that traffic. Yes. But to those numbers, not yet. We actually have gotten a couple of phone calls at the visitor center in the last week of people who actually had trips planned to come to Ocean Springs in the month of May. And they have actually asked, is there stuff to do? Can we still come? And we're like, yes, come on. We're ready for you.
So one of the challenges I saw from last weekend was people walking on sidewalks and trying to practice social distancing and wandering out into the street, particularly around Government Street. But that, you know, the good news is that people came and they really, you know, all that pent up demand, they wanted to go eat and enjoy the downtown life, but they also wanted to do it safely. What's the status of Government Street these days?
Well, you know, Government Street is kind of our nightlife street. You know, we have two main downtown streets, and Government Street actually houses more restaurants than the other downtown streets. So it is always busy just in general. You know, now that they are open 50% capacity, they got their patios open. So again, everybody's working their hardest to do the social distancing. Many restaurants have moved out their patio tables, sectioned them out, spaced them out. So when you drive down Government Street, it looks very, very busy. You know, not 100% what it has been, but people are out and about and our restaurants are happy. Last week, recently, we actually had a town hall meeting with the mayor. And one of the things that the restaurants said when they begin to open up is they were like, we're going to have a staffing problem because of the influx of people that's going to want to come. But we're going to do it. We're going to open up. You know, don't stop us. Let us do it. And it has definitely proven to be true. It is very busy. You know, there's no live music yet. But as for the folks doing the curbside drinks, being on the patio, getting something to eat, we've seen so many people back out. It's very busy and we're excited.
So what's the status of maybe potentially closing down some portion of Government Street?
You know, that is actually still, from my understanding, many of the individuals in the city are for it, but we just need a little bit more time to kind of see how everything opens back up. Eventually, that would be a really cool thing to add to downtown, like maybe once a weekend to close sections of some of the streets just to have more activity. Because, like I said, we are a very busy town. We have a lot of people out there. But as of right now, from my understanding, the city is going to hold off a little bit longer and see how the restaurants are handling things right now.
Yeah, I don't know what the negatives are. That's what I said to Shay when we talked this week, but it seems like a smart idea. I mean, it really does.
Yeah.
And it seems almost like necessary idea because, you know, with that reality of potentially closing off some section of Government Street, with that reality is the fact that there are more people walking on the sidewalks who want to practice social distancing. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out. I think it's a good idea, but yeah. Hey, why don't we do this, Cynthia? When we come back after the break, we'll just continue the conversation. But this is Cynthia Sutton from the Ocean Springs Chamber and Main Street Tourism Bureau in Ocean Springs, of course. And we'll continue the conversation after this break.
Follow SuperTalk Mississippi Gulf Coast 103.1 on Facebook, facebook.com/SuperTalkMSCoast103.1.
Talking to the people that help make the coast such a unique place to live. This is Coast View with Ricky Matthews on Super Talk Mississippi Gulf Coast 103.1.
Welcome back to Coast View. We have Cynthia Sutton with us today. She's the executive director from the Ocean Springs Chamber of Commerce and Main Street Tourism Bureau. And anyway, it's been a fun conversation. What a wonderful town that you have the opportunity to work in. And I was mentioning to you offline, I had a great conversation this week with Katie Daniel, who's an artist, a freelance artist in Ocean Springs. Mm-hmm. Super talented. And as I said on the show, she's even probably a better mother. So she was very inspiring, very articulate, very good communicator. And, you know, to be honest with you, when we posted it, I expected, you know, 300 or 400 views. I mean, it's approaching like 1,100 views.
Wow.
And it's all organic. And you know what? Looking back on it now, it shouldn't surprise anybody. Because if you think about the points that Craig Ray from Mississippi Development Authority Visit Mississippi and Steve Azor made last week. The beauty of Mississippi is that we have this incredibly rich art and culture that, you know, whether it be literature or just, you know, paintings, or in the case of Katie, she does both watercolor and pottery. But if you think about the rich history we have here and the amount of talented people who have their heart and souls connected to this place, shouldn't surprise anyone that Katie's the conversation with Katie's been so popular. But you see it every day, don't you?
Yeah, I do. You know, kudos to Katie. I am familiar with her. We do know each other from our time, I guess you can say, in church. I'm not surprised, but yes, you know, we have a huge artist community here on the Mississippi Gulf Coast, from Bay St. Louis to Ocean Springs to Pascagoula to Moss Point. You know, in Ocean Springs, you know, art is one of our main things that we focus on. So we have artists for the Ocean Springs Art Association alone. You know, they oversee 300 artists. We have the Ocean Springs Collaborative. We have artists through the Mary C., the Walter Anderson Museum of Art, with their new director, Julian. There is art everywhere. You know, we try to put art in everything that we do, from our festivals to our events to one of our newest restaurants. The Rooftop has put a mural on the side of their building. We hope to continue that effort a little bit throughout Ocean Springs. So, yeah, there is art everywhere. And we're in constant communication with artists and trying to come up with some fun projects.
Well, Vicki Applewhite and I worked together at the Sun Herald, and we worked together over in Alabama. Yeah. And she told me all about Julian. And Julian's actually going to be on next week.
Awesome.
The work he's doing with his new podcast and the way he's spreading the word about the Walter Anderson Museum, it's really inspiring. It's going to really help the city. It's really going to help.
It's creative,
the city.
And that's what we need.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, you really do. So why don't we do this? Go down a laundry list of items. So we've got just a few minutes left. I just want to make sure we cover some of the big points here. But tell me about Smoothie King.
Okay. Yes. Okay. So you know, in Ocean Springs, you know, since for many years actually, you know, we've been trying to grow our economic development a little bit throughout town, in downtown, the east side of town, all throughout town. I like to say downtown, uptown, all around town. So we try to kind of keep that going. It's kind of interesting to see that during this time, we have actually still had development going on. And when you mentioned Smoothie King, they are still taking shape. Their building is developing on Highway 90. You know, their growth, they're going to develop. You know, not too long ago, Woody's expanded. So there's a lot of growth in town. You know, we have a new complex in kind of the middle of town, close to Walmart, with Sports Clips, a new Vet, Lost Pizza Company. If you have not tried their pizza out, you'll have to. So it's kind of interesting to see development is still happening during this time.
That's great to see. You got the renovation at the train depot.
Yes. Oh, okay. So, you know, the train depot, we are a Main Street community. So we like to try to do the best we can to preserve any of our historical landmarks or things like that. And the L&N Depot, which is where we are, where we work out of here, is 113 years old. And it has been around for a long time. So just like what you had mentioned about the visitors earlier, since we get so many visitors that come in every month, 400 to 500 that come into the visitor center, let me start over. The L&N Depot train station houses the Chamber of Commerce and the town visitor center, as well as the gift shop realization. So we get a lot of foot traffic, like I said, the 400 to 500 that come through here every month. Since we've had to kind of close to the outside public, we've always still been here doing work and working with our businesses. But without that foot traffic, we've actually begun to do a few renovations on this little 100-year-old building here. And we actually pulled up some carpet, and it revealed the historic floors in some of these areas. So specifically in the visitor center, it is gorgeous, more than 100 years old, restored. We only had one little board we had to replace. It is gorgeous. So we can't wait to show the community how gorgeous the inside of this building is becoming.
So you use this as an opportunity as well to get businesses online. So we've got less than a minute left. So tell us about that real quick. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So it's kind of cool. Our business community has been a lot of face-to-face, in hand. You know, we visit them all the time, hand in hand. We visit them all the time. And, you know, we like to talk to them face-to-face. And a lot of their presence is come into the shop, get the customer service experience. We haven't been able to do that in about 2 months. So it has actually forced a lot of our businesses to join the technology world. So have we. And they now have online websites, many of them, shops, you know, almost, I don't think any shop now doesn't have an Instagram page. So that's cool.
That's great. I'm glad to hear that. Cynthia, we'll come back to you in a couple of weeks. It's been refreshing. I love Ocean Springs. Who doesn't? You know, when you look at the collection of communities that make up Coastal Mississippi, we're what a special place we live in. So anyway, Cynthia Sutton, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you later.
Thank you. It's been fun.
Subscribe for free to the Coast View Podcast on iTunes, Google Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts.